Welcome everyone. I'm delighted you can join us today as we begin our 3 days of prayer and fasting for revival in us and in the world that we live in. We had planned these meetings to celebrate Pentecost, and we had such a party in mind to celebrate the birthday of the church. But this pesky virus has caused us to still be on lockdown, and we're still having to operate from our homes. But it may well have stopped us from being able to party, but it cannot stop us from being able to pray. Amen. Now, we're delighted to welcome back Evangelist Kristian Lythe and of M16 Revival, and you're going to be hearing from him each evening. And before we do tonight, let's just take a moment to prepare our own hearts and our own focus for the mission that God has called us all to, each and every one of us, the ministry of reconciliation. You remember in our study of Luke, in going deeper, you'll remember that in Luke's account of John the Baptist's ministry, it's the only account that records the final part of Isaiah's quote when it says in Luke 3:6, "And all flesh shall see the salvation of God." Tonight, as we pray together for breakthrough, let's get our own hearts ready to bear fruit to the great God that we serve. Let's pray together that Medway will come to know our Master.
Let's go into a time of worship. Thank you, God, that you are faithful, that you are good. We lift you high, Lord God. We give you praise. We give you our worship. Come and have your way, Lord God. Lifted up. this city, God. Thank you.
Evangelist Kristian Lythe here. How you doing? We're excited about what God's going to do in this Medway Revival Awakening. So we want to welcome you personally tonight. We're going to be taking these 3 nights to really seek God's will concerning the Medway. We're believing God not just for a move in one town, but we're believing God for a move of God in every town and village in the Medway. We want to see revival. We want to see each believer stirred in their relationship with God in a new way. So I don't know where you are tonight. Are you walking closely with the Lord, or have you walked away from the Lord? We want to encourage you to be revived and renewed. And we want an awakening. We want something that's going to shake the church and shake the world. We know that the lockdown has caused many to question faith or maybe renew their commitment to faith. But we want to pray. We want to press in for these 3 days. We as an M16 Revival team, we've been traveling throughout the UK, and we've had the privilege to visit about 40 different areas of England, Scotland and Wales to pray for revival. And the idea is just simply to turn up in churches, in areas. We particularly feel called to the East Coast. And so we've been traveling from Aberdeen all the way down through Felixstowe, Scarborough, these kind of areas, and Ramsgate and St. Peter's, where we've been praying for revival and running revival tours. We came to Chatham last year, where we saw people firsthand give their lives to Christ on the streets, which was awesome. And then we saw believers in the church respond by consecrating their lives afresh to God. And we felt that this was so unprecedented. There was something unique about what God wanted to do in the Medway. Well, the last 8 weeks we've been praying for you guys during the lockdown, and we went ahead with these 3 days to call the church to prayer and fasting. And so there's a key verse that we've got. We felt over the time of prayer and since we visited last time that God wants to break some new spiritual ground in the Medway. And so if you're following us on YouTube or you're following us in the Zoom meetings, the key scriptures are Hosea 10 verse 12, which is, "Break up your fallow ground, for it's time to seek the Lord that he rains righteousness upon you." God wants us to sow some good seed of the gospel in the Medway, but we need to break up the fallow ground of our own hearts and our own lives. We need to get prepared. John the Baptist says, "I'm a voice crying in the wilderness, preparing the way of the Lord." So part of revival or awakening, we've got to be prepared first. If thousands of people just got saved right now, packed the churches, would we be ready? Can God fit all of the lost in the church anywhere? And so we need to basically prepare right now our hearts before the Lord and cry out to him. Maybe there's a new urgency. Maybe there's a new hunger during the lockdown, maybe based on emotion, or maybe it's a spiritual rebirthing that you're experiencing right now. But we're going to come alongside the churches in the Medway simply to serve, simply to lead prayer, and simply to be listening to what God's saying. So if you have a word and you want to send that in, send it to info@m16revival.com. And we will be in touch with you. Or if you're from a local church, contact your local church and just say, I've been following the Medway Revival Awakening, and I want to tell you a little bit about what I believe God's saying. So we want to be open to what God's saying, not just through myself or our team, but also through you as a believer who live locally in the Medway. Let's pray right now. Father, we come to you right now in the name of Jesus, and we just simply ask you for a revival awakening in the Medway. Lord, the churches are working hard. People are serving one another. There's some good stuff. But we just pray personally for the life of each believer and each Christian to be revived and stirred. We all need it. So Lord, we pray 3 days, sanctify us. 3 days, renew us. 3 days, deal with us and bring us to that place of freedom in you, in Jesus' name. Amen. 2 Chronicles 7 verse 14. This is a quick quoted scripture when it comes to revival. And we know about it as church leaders, but it's so significant in this time that I believe we can actually apply it to this time of the lockdown. It says in 2 Chronicles chapter 7 verse 13, when I shut up the heaven and there is no rain, or command the locusts to devour the land, or send pestilences among my people, if my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then I hear from heaven, will forgive their sin and heal their land. God says when pestilence comes, or when I send pestilence. You know, this was an interesting scripture when the temple was dedicated to God. And the glory of God came in such an amazing way that the priests could not stand to minister because of the glory of God. There was an actual awakening. That's where people feared the temple, because they knew that God was in it. The priest couldn't go in without sin, because if he was there in sin, he might be dragged out. He had to have the fear of the Lord and a sense of holiness and dress in the right garments. And we no longer have to wear these priestly garments, because now we're clothed in the garments of Jesus Christ, because of his death and his resurrection on the cross. And by grace we are saved. So we're applying this scripture as a promise to God that if my people will humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then I'll hear from heaven, forgive their sin and heal their land. In every generation there has been awakenings. In every generation, the 1700s, we saw John and Charles Wesley blaze a trail up and down the United Kingdom. And then in the 1800s, we saw other preachers. We saw the birthing of missions, missions to China under Hudson Taylor, and the bursting out of these things. And in the 1900s, or late 1800s and early 1900s, we saw great revivals through Evan Roberts of the Welsh Revival, and Smith Wigglesworth came on the scene, and the Salvation Army was birthed in the early 1900s and under William Booth. And we've seen these great awakenings. And in a sense, these next 3 days, we're just saying simply, God, do it again. We need an awakening. I need an awakening. You need an awakening. We all need an awakening. We are approaching the Pentecost week. And Jesus said to the disciples, wait in Jerusalem till you've been clothed with power from on high. And they waited in Acts 1 verse 14, 120, praying consistently, waiting for 50 days for the Holy Spirit. And then in Acts 2 verse 1, it says, suddenly there came a sound from heaven as of a rushing mighty wind, and it filled the whole house where they were sitting, and they saw what seemed to be tongues of fire that rested on each of them. I mean, they were all filled. Something happened. It was a sudden awakening from heaven. It was a sudden sound from heaven. We don't want something that's from the earth. We want something that's from God. We want His Spirit to come upon us. In Acts 4 verse 29, they prayed for boldness as they were in a difficult situation. And God came in the place and He shook that place. And the Bible says they were all filled and they spoke the word of God with boldness. What is an awakening? An awakening is when you suddenly come to the realization that how you're living is not the right way. Think about Jonah in the whale. He prayed to God. He remembered God, which is the Hebrew word intercession. He remembered God. He interceded, and God spoke to the fish, and he spoke to the fish, and the fish puked him on dry ground. You see, it's significant, because when we pray and we turn to God, something significant happens. I remember I had a dream where I was asleep in my dream. It's amazing you can be sleeping in your dream. That means I was in a very deep sleep, like almost a slumber had come upon me. I was in the church building, I was in the balcony in the church building and I was asleep and I woke up in my dream. So I was still sleeping, but I was awake in my dream. And I couldn't believe that I was sleeping in the church. Many Christians, even right now, are sleeping spiritually. There's a heavy weight of this world. Think about the spirit of fear that's been so actively working amongst us in the UK and also globally. People have actually physically felt fear. That people are sleeping as believers under this spirit of fear. And God wants to wake us up. George Whitfield, the great preacher who preached alongside John Wesley, he has a quote and he said, "The church is in a deep sleep. Nothing but a loud voice can awaken it. Nothing but a loud voice can awaken it." Can the church be awake in this hour? I believe there's going to be an awakening in the Medway. I believe there's going to be an awakening in every village. There needs to be an awakening of prayer. There needs to be an awakening of a passion for people, a passion for the lost. There needs to be a reviving or an awakening of eternal values. See, we're not living in the temporal world. We're living for eternity. Our kingdom is an eternal kingdom. When we die, we're going to go to heaven, and we're going to go to heaven forever. So we need an awakening of eternal values and eternal principles to come back to the church. We also need an awakening that Jesus is going to return soon. I remember in the 1980s, all the church would talk about was the return of Jesus. Well, I'm telling you more than ever now that Jesus is about to return. But before he returns, there's going to be an awakening. I remember the Philippian jailer in Acts 16, when Paul and Silas were simply singing to God. God shook that prison cell and the man awoke from his slumber and he said to Paul, "What am I going to do? What am I going to do? What do I need to do to be saved?" And Paul said, "Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ and you shall be saved." He was asleep. He was asleep. There was no sense of God. Paul and Silas were singing and they felt the presence of God. But this Philippian jailer, he was asleep around God's anointed man. And suddenly there was a shaking happening where he woke up. I believe that God wants to send a shaking. He wants to send an awakening that people in their houses and their homes will start to fall on their knees and give their lives to Jesus Christ. I heard a word that was given to a young man. And the word was simply this, that God's going to use you powerfully. And when you walk past a bus stop or down a street, people are going to fall under the conviction of the Holy Spirit. I know a man who actually worked like that, Charles Finney. If you can get the book, How to Experience Revival by Charles Finney, he was used in revival. He would walk into a factory and there was a woman there who was literally criticizing the preacher. And she criticized and she criticized and she criticized. And then suddenly the presence of God came into that factory and she fell off her seat and started to kneel down. Suddenly she began to weep and ask forgiveness of her sins. She started to be awakened. She started to be awakened. Suddenly another person in the factory got down and knelt down and wept and asked God to forgive them. And then suddenly another person, until a domino effect happened where the Spirit of God came into that factory and literally the whole factory had to be closed for that day for people were seeking God. That's an awakening. God wants to do the same thing in you, in your house, in your family. My brother, he called me after 18 years of struggling in his relationship with God during the lockdown. He says, "Is Jesus going to return soon?" I said, "I don't know. But what I do know is you've got your time right now to turn to him and he's given you a second chance." Well, within a week, he'd committed his life back to Jesus and is determined to learn more of the time that he's wasted. He's hungry for more of God. See, God wants to bring an awakening to the Medway. He wants to break up some fallow ground in our hearts. He wants to wake the church up. Maybe you've been called by God. God called you as a boy or God called you recently, but you went off course. He says, "If my people who are called by my name." Well, think about that word if. If there's an awakening, Lord, there's hope. If you would come and pour out your spirit on the church, there is hope. Lord, if you would start saving people on the street, there is hope. If you would start saving my family, Lord, do it, Lord, do it, Lord. If there's an awakening. There was an awakening to a certain man called Nehemiah. Nehemiah had a nice job. We didn't have a car, but he had a nice life. He was the cupbearer to the king. And one day he heard the news that the wall of Jerusalem had been broken down and the gates had been burned with fire. It was the worst news of his life. Suddenly, he fasted and prayed for many days. He wept and he said, God, it's time to rebuild the wall of Jerusalem, for it's broken down. There's an urgency that was imparted to his spirit, and he knew that he could no longer continue because he was about praying for an awakening, for the wall to be rebuilt. God is looking for builders. He's looking for church leaders. He's looking for normal people like you and I to be awake spiritually, to contend, to fight for the future of Christianity in this nation. We're fighting abortion laws. We're fighting false religions. We're fighting spiritual principalities and powers, and witchcraft is on the rise. But we should not fear. We should be bold as lions, and we should take on the enemy, but not in the flesh. We should take on in the realm of the spirit. And this is why we call these 3 days together for revival awakening. We can't fight without the Holy Spirit. We can't fight without being full of Him. We need His power. We need it to be awake, spiritually speaking. And it's going to cause two or three to join together in unity. Where two was divided before, two are going to partner again for the sake of the gospel. I want to call you forth for an awakening. He says, if my people. Well, we've lived in the me people generation. The rise of Facebook and social media has put me and self at the center. But God says, if my people. See, we're not our own people. We were bought with a price. We've been purchased by the blood of Jesus, and we're not our own. We're sons and daughters of the living God. We need to realize right now that we're sons and daughters of Him and not get our identity from what we do. Some people during the lockdown have not been able to work, and they've not been able to move, and they've lost the sense of identity because their identity was not in God. Their identity was in something else, was in their job, is in what they do. As a Christian, we don't get our identity from what we do. We get our identity from whose we are, and we belong to God. See the prodigal son who walked away from his father when he was eating the pig's food and he lost all of his money. He suddenly realized it was better to be a servant in his father's house than to be eating pig's food. So he decided to return. You see, awakening is all about realization. Lord, I realize that the church does not have what it needs to win the lost. It doesn't have what it takes to rule and govern spiritually. Lord, we need you. We have failed and we need to humble ourselves. We need an awakening. We need an awakening. He says, if my people who are called. See, God has called you. Now, I remember God calling me as a 15-year-old. He called me, put his hand upon my life. And my life was up and down as a Christian. And that might be your story. But you know what? When you're called and God's hand is upon you, He might let you go for a little bit, but He's going to bring you back. And there's certain things that you're allowed to do and certain things you're not allowed to do when you know and you have a sense of calling. God is calling you as a believer to reach out to the Medway. He's calling you to seek His face like never before. And there needs to be an awakening during this time. There needs to be an urgency. See, revival is about urgency. Before revival breaks in, there is prayer, and there is preparation, and there is intercession. And we need to intercede for the local area. Reinhard Bonnke, we know, who had mobilized millions of people in Africa for crusades. Now, Daniel Klender, his successor under CFAN, I think it was this last week, had reached out to 6 million people online. Unprecedented audiences, unprecedented crowds. God is surely bringing in a great harvest. But to get this kind of harvest, Reinhard would send intercessors into Africa to break up the spiritual ground. They would bind demonic strongholds that are holding the people captive. And they would fast many days for God to move. And then Reinhard would come in with his team and great crowds would come and many would respond to the Lord. It's the same in this day. We need an awakening of intercessors. We need an awakening of people who will mobilize the church to pray and intercede. 3 days of revival, Medway awakening. And what does it look like? It is like Esther going to the king saying, we're going to fast for the Jewish nation for 3 days. And then I'm going to go to the king and pray that he holds out his scepter and so I can speak to him. We know the story how Esther fasted 3 days. She spoke to the king and she saved her generation. She saved the Jewish people from the onslaught of the evil Haman. You know what? It's the same in this day. God wants to awaken His church. He wants to awaken His people. What does awakening look like? Well, for me, it looks like falling in love with Jesus again. Having that fresh, renewed confidence Revelation puts it like this: come back to your first love. I remember being in a C-fan meeting, and I didn't plan to be there, but a man was preaching, and as he was preaching, he was speaking about the love of God. And I remember in that moment, I said, Lord, I love you. Lord, I've been involved in activity. I'm busy. I'm worried. I'm anxious. I've been involved in a lot of things. I keep going for you. But Lord, I want to tell you that I love you. My love for you is the most important. My love for you is the most important. See, that's revival. Revival is the rebirth of a love for God. And I want to encourage you today to come back to God. I want to encourage you today to pray and then to see these 3 days and to fast. If you've not been fasting today, try and go without a meal tomorrow. As we pray together on Zoom, or if you can get your group together, if you're not part of certain churches that have registered, get going, get praying and interceding for the Medway. For we believe in God for a breakthrough in the Medway towns and villages. We believe in God for new churches to start, new leaders to rise up. And that could be you. He says, if my people who are called by my name will humble themselves, will. Think about that word will. Sometimes God needs to break the will. He needs to break our will. Our will is not his will. Jesus taught us to pray. Pray this prayer. Your kingdom come. Your will be done. Your will be done. Not my will, but your will be done. We pray for the Medway towns and the Medway believers. We pray for the United Kingdom that the will of every Christian will line up with the will of God. And we'll start praying, Lord, your kingdom come, your will be done. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Well, we're going to leave it there right now. We're going to pray together. And then we're going to go live on Zoom where many of us are going to be praying for 1 hour. And we want to press in to God for revival for the Medway. Let's pray right now. Father, we just simply believe you for revival in the Medway. Lord Jesus, we're just human. Sometimes we're weak, but Lord, we need you and we need your strength today. Lord, we pray for an awakening in the Medway, an awakening in each believer, an awakening in each family. We pray that you'd come and you release your strength and your power and your might over these next 3 days. We pray we'll meet with you. You'll break up some hard ground. Things that have held us back for such a long time would break free. They would be gone from our lives. And there'll be a new stirring for revival. There'll be a new hope. There'll be new life. Lord, husbands and wives would unite. Sons and daughters would unite. Families would unite. Churches would unite. People who fell out in the ministry would unite. There'll be an awakening. Lord, you'd wake people up in their dream. You'd wake people up in their sleep. You'd wake people up in the church. There would be an awakening. Raise up John and Charles Wesley again. Brothers who would move throughout England and preach the gospel. Lord, we believe you. You can do it again. Raise up the healing evangelists like George Jeffries and Wigglesworth. God, do it again, we pray. Lord, the great history of Chatham and the Medway. Lord, the boats that used to be built for the king and the history that used to be there in Chatham. Lord, revive it for the kingdom of God. Let Chatham be known. Let Gillingham be known. Let Greyham be known and Strood be known and Maidstone be known for the glory of God. In the name of Jesus, Lord, release your people into works of service. Release your people into ministry in the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. Well, we're just going to be waiting on the Lord right now for the next hour. We're going to be pressing in to God. If you want to find more information about what we do, go to m16revival.com or you can email us personally at info@m16revival.com on anything you believe God's saying about the Medway. We're here not just to pray and to tell God what he should be doing. We want to hear personally from God about what he is doing, what he wants to say regarding the Medway. So we want to write down, we want to journal these next 3 days. If you have just linked with us, make sure you order the book, How to Experience Revival by Charles Finney. How to Have a Revival by Charles Finney. It's an old book and it's quite challenging. But one thing that it will do for each person will start to challenge them spiritually about where they're at and get before God and say, God, purify my heart anew. I want a renewed relationship with you. Well, we're charged for these next 3 days. We've got 2 days remaining. We'll be back here tomorrow night at 8 o'clock. Come and join us. There'll be worship and there'll be praise. And then we'll be back here on Thursday and Friday. And then we'll be running a workshop on the Saturday for evangelism. So if you want to come and join us and participate in that workshop, it's going to be on the topic, how does church look like after the lockdown? How are we going to progress? How do we share the gospel? What new strategies can we institute and influence people? How can we move ahead? What's the future of the church? Well, if you're interested in that, start at 12 o'clock. We'll send you the details and you can register on info@m16revival.com and we'll send you all the details that you need. Well, God bless you. We're going to go live on Zoom right now and we're looking forward to linking with you guys and praying and interceding for the Medway. God bless you. Have a fantastic day.